Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Well, last week, just an unbelievable performance we saw from a quarterback at the very top of his game. He was just toying with that secondary. Can he lead them to another win in this one? It's the Buccaneers going up against the Cardinals.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Nice job. Nice patience right there. Put him on the right side. Let him work his way across. Put the ball in his hands and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
Here we go now.
The first carry now. This is Johnson. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still running.
Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Levante David. Not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, here to Coates. Had a great strong move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that. But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
They go back to the ground with Johnson. A big hit. Knocked down sideways at the 23. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step. And that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course,
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you?
3-19! 3-19!
They'll look to throw now on first down. And that's caught inside the 30. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Oh, a scram for the football, and he's going to come down with it. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
One of the selling points of the corner route is usually the receiver is able to move away from the defender. But in this case, he didn't get that far away.
All right, here we go.
Again, he'll drop to throw. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. What a great weapon. So often, such a big mismatch.
And there's no route he can't run. You name it, he's going to do it. And he's a matchup nightmare for the defense. No matter who they put on him, he's going to win the battle.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Open now to get back in the end zone on this fourth possession. Trying to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped. 10 yards, first down.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field, so it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. More from the desert after this. Back now as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Oh, thank you. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And Corliss with it over the middle. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A very solid gain of 27. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house from Buccaneer TD. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field.
Let's go.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Brought in by Coates. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
All right, here we go. 3, 9, 2.
Back to throw now on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
They'll try again with the arm here on second down. Going for a right side here, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the play. On first down, he'll drop to throw. His throw caught at about the 5. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Back to throw again. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Sammy Coates, as the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals are in for six.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels...
So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had an ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Out of the gun now on third down. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close.
Accelerating, and off he goes. Touchdown, Cardinals. A big play there with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Cardinals are in for six.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. He's at the 50, 30, 20, 10, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play back. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
He's got some space. He's going to let this one go deep, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching. Huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. DeJuan Smoot He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Back now here on EA Sports. It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish.
Here we go now.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Now Johnson, and able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. Call it an 8-yard gain, much better shape now on 3rd and just 1 yard. And in this situation with the lead 4th quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And he's top 5 in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
Set up a throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that. Truly leading his team right now towards victory.
3 touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Throw. And this one's caught. And their 4th quarter lead grows by a couple more. And around the goal line, especially on 2-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A nice gain of 21 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. They had the lead in the forth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
So out now come the Cardinals. Johnson, and he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We got the
rush coming, and he's taken down. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And complete on the right side, it's Corliss. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. They were still throwing with a comfortable... Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They take over with great field position. They've got the big lead. Most would say they should kneel it, but the key word there is should. You never know here.
You never know. That's the exact play that should happen. But some people like stats. You know, some people like to put more things up on the board. But kneel down is usually the right play here.
We'll see what they do in this situation. That one looks like he'll throw here. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. This game's still fairly well in hand. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. So here we go, first and 10 now. Looking to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. Back to throw here. Forced out to his left. And that is caught. But he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss a one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfires.
The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
It's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Charles, it's one thing to win, it's another thing to win.